Hi, this is Tracy. I'm your Sunday host on Out Late But Great. This week, we are discussing religion. Jim from Atlanta posed three questions for us. The first one has to do with our relationship with religion. The second one has to do with a viewer question, is it possible to pray away the gay? And the third question has to do with our childhood. Jim wanted us to tell a funny anecdote from possible Sunday school, something that we attended religious as a child. And if we don't have a story with that, to talk about an elementary school story. I did not really attend church as a child. I went occasionally. I really don't have any funny stories about that. And not to sound very maudlin, but elementary school was not my finest years. So I think I'm going to skip all that because of the subject matter being so vast this week. And trying to pull together a few coherent thoughts. So let's get started with the video. So what is my relationship with religion? Well, brief history. I did not attend church as a child. I was always a seeker. I went to a Catholic college trying to find God. I became a born-again Christian when my marriage was at its lowest point, because those are the people that helped me out. I would say my relationship with religion right now is I am not part of an organized religion. I don't agree with a lot of things that are said and a lot of agendas that are used. I have a personal relationship with my Creator. And I'm very comfortable with that. But I also believe faith is very personal. I think the people who go out and shout the loudest about their religion are trying to convince themselves of something. I don't believe in bullying others for their beliefs. But I also don't believe that people should impose their beliefs on me. My relationship with religion is one that is at peace now. But it took a long time to get there. It took a lot of years of searching. And it also came with coming to terms with who I am and allowing myself to be the person that God created me to be. I have certain attributes that were given to me from my hair color to blue eyes to being a woman to being born in the United States to having the sexual identity that I do. I was given these things so that I could be the unique person that I need to be at this time and space. And to do the things that my heart desires, because the desires are placed there for me to accomplish things, to learn. That's pretty much my view of religion.
When these people say that being that sexual orientation is a choice,
yeah.
A lot of these people are bisexual or gay people,
yeah,
in their hearts who've chosen to be straight.
Right.
So being gay isn't a choice. For some people, being straight is a choice. The closet, to remain in the closet, that's the choice they've made. And they resent those of us who didn't choose to remain closeted, who decided to live with some integrity and be who we are and, yeah, live openly. So those people are very religious people who were spiritually abused. You know, they
yeah,
bought into this idea that there is this higher power, that there is this Jesus Christ, and he's going to throw up if you are who he created you to be. And you people are, it's really spiritual abuse. Wayne Besson writes very movingly about this at Truth Wins Out. It's spiritual abuse. You've pitted somebody's religious life against their intimate needs. And for some people, they feel that salvation and eternity is worth 70 years, mm-hmm, of no intimacy, 70 years of living a lie and living in the closet and being at war with yourself. I think it's a tragedy. And it's malpractice, religious malpractice.
Yeah.
So is it possible to pray away the gay? I don't think so. I think it's possible to change a behavior, even if it means you're not being congruent with yourself. People do it all the time with all sorts of things. But I don't think it's possible to change something that is completely innate and be happy with it. Let's take a look at this clip.
I'm married now. I have a beautiful wife. She's pregnant, 9 months pregnant. I'm so happy that God has given me natural affection for a woman, that's a miracle right there. I remember on our wedding night, I mean, not to give too much detail, but when we finally consummated our marriage, I mean, I literally screamed at the top of my lungs, Jesus! Like, I was so happy! He delivered me, you know? I love women, and I love my wife's body. I love her physically, and it's holy, and God is good, and He created sex, and He wants us to enjoy it in the proper context, and guess what? He can do it. Even for those who struggle with homosexuality their whole life, He can set them straight.
Really? This guy really thinks that he's straight. I mean, with his little foppish scarf around his neck and his mannerisms and how vigorous he's trying to convince himself of such. You can't pray away being gay. I tried it. For this guy to say he's into women, it's a brainwashing. He still desires men. He has to, if he was truly gay. I spent years wanting a normal life, to stay married, to give my kids a stable home, to be part of a normal society, so-called normal society. But inside, in here, I was constantly lusting after women, looking at women, dreaming about women. And I prayed and prayed, and it never went away. Sometimes you just have to embrace who you are. Certain innate things are not going to just disappear because you try to make yourself. If it's part of you, it's part of you. We struggled so long to just be who we need to be. And that's okay to be who we need to be. Science is on our side. You can't pray this away.
The fact is, the problem with all this is I'm not saying that people shouldn't have the option to get treatment for whatever they want to try to change their behavior. I'm saying that there's no evidence that it can be done. There's evidence that it could be harmful. And by putting it out there consistently that this is an option, you may be shaming and harming people, young people, who are having great difficulty and ambivalence about their sexual orientation.
Just as we are made with so much variation, I think we have variation in belief or capability of belief. What works for one person is not going to work for another person. I think there are many paths to God. Now, you'll get a hardcore Christian saying, no, there's only one path, the way, the truth, and the life. But yet there are hundreds of denominations of that one variation. If your church, if your belief system is making you feel bad, then maybe that's not the place you're supposed to be. After all, we're supposed to be congruent with what's going on around us. That's the only way we learn. Maybe if your belief system is teaching you that you're bad and wrong about something that you know is right, maybe it's time to find a new belief system. You can still be a Christian. There are plenty out there that accept homosexuals and embrace us. Because they look at the Bible overall, in the cultural as well as the historical concept, instead of just from some literal word of God that they choose to pick in, out of the Bible and use to further their agenda. There's nothing wrong with us. You have to believe it.
This is who God made me to be.
Oh, that's so nice.
And of course I came out because if I don't, I will never be whole. I could have imagined myself back in that spot again.
Yeah, yeah.
But another compelling reason is because young people in every corner of America are being told by their churches. Mm-hmm. And their parents are echoing what the churches are telling them. that they are damaged goods, and they are not. Mm-hmm. And we have to, I have to stand up. I am uniquely positioned in my culture of country music, and they already, as my dad said, he already knew me. And country fans know me. They already think I'm a heck of a gal, a patriot, a good girl, and I am a lesbian, and I have been the whole time.
The Bible lists a lot of sins. Coveting, murder, prostitution, talking back to parents, alcoholism, gluttony, not being kind to the poor, working on the Sabbath. Of the whole list of all the sins in the Bible, the only sin that would deny love is homosexuality. It doesn't make sense if God is love. You're not damaged. Go out and find out a faith that works within your heart. You're made who you're made to be. Embrace it, because that's what God wants of us. Have a great week, everybody. Bye.